Central Florida weekend. Yeah.
And despite the fact that Igor is so far away from us now, it's almost in Canada, we're still feeling the effects here. So it takes a long time for everything to kind of catch up and subside in the water. And take a look at where Igor is right now. You'll see it's very near Newfoundland. So that's why they're feeling stuff up along the east coast. But we're still impacted by the swells and the rip currents here. Igor, by the way, is almost completely extratropical, which means it's losing its tropical characteristics as it races quickly to the northeast. We also have Lisa, by the way. If you missed the news this morning, Lisa was upgraded, got a name as of 5 a.m. It is near the Cape Verde Islands. This is about 3,000 miles away from us, and it's going to hang out here right through the rest of the week and into the upcoming weekend. It's only going to move a little bit, meander to the west, so Lisa's really not being steered by any strong currents. Eventually, though, it should curve north and west, and it looks like it's going to stay away from us completely in Central Florida. However, I wish I could say the same thing about this. We have another area of low pressure that is not going to develop anytime soon, but the computer models for a while now have tried to develop this by the end of next week. Not the end of this week, but the end of next week as it grows and builds, moves through the Caribbean closer to Florida. Still very early, a lot to watch, but you need to keep checking back. We will definitely keep you posted. Certainly today, though, the impacts of the tropical weather are going to be felt along the coast. We still have the swells, we still have the strong rip currents, and the seas are between 5 and 7 feet. So they have come down a little bit from yesterday, but we still have the small craft advisory in effect with things gradually improving, although the rip current danger is going to be with us right through the weekend. Meanwhile, right now, we've got just a few isolated passing showers that have been rolling in off the Atlantic, and a few have actually made their way inland. So Brevard County, Osceola County, not a lot of rain. This is what we're going to see, just kind of hit and miss, fast-moving showers as we head through the afternoon and evening. The rest of us will be partly cloudy with those temperatures climbing. In fact, we're already at 88 at the Villages, 86 Palm Coast in Sanford, and it's 86 right now in Melbourne. Future scan picks up on those passing showers with those really breezy east winds expected today. And the showers then will ride along those winds from east to west through the afternoon and evening, and even linger into the overnight tonight as well. Now, with our east winds, our beach temperatures will stay a little cooler this afternoon. We'll top out at 88 at Daytona Beach and also Melbourne. And our inland areas are headed into the lower 90s, 92 in Sanford today and 91 in Orlando. Here's a peek at the 7-day forecast showing rain chances beginning to gradually increase as the atmosphere starts to get a little more moist. That means a little higher humidity expected as we head into the upcoming weekend.